Welcome to The Lead. I'm Jake Tapper. We begin with our politics lead. President Trump, under increasing pressure, is continuing to try and discredit the federal law enforcement investigation into how Russia interfered in the 2016 presidential election and whether the president obstructed that investigation. Today, again, on Twitter, the president called special counsel Robert Mueller's probe a witch hunt. He did it in all caps, so you know he really means it. The president has been trying to spin the newly released memos by Mueller and federal prosecutors by falsely claiming this all, quote, totally clears the president, unquote. The truth is the exact opposite. Mueller and prosecutors seem to be providing us with clues as to where this all might be headed, with key information about individual one, better known as President Donald J. Trump. Let's start with the Russia probe. We've now learned that the Trump Tower Moscow project, the one that the president and his team lied about throughout 2016, is considered by Mueller directly relevant to the Russia investigation. Mueller's sentencing memo about former Trump fixer Michael Cohen reads, quote, "The fact that Cohen continued to work on the project and discuss it with individual one, Donald Trump, well into the campaign was material to the ongoing congressional and special counsel investigations, particularly because it occurred at a time of sustained efforts by the Russian government to interfere with the U.S. presidential election," unquote. Mueller decried Cohen's, quote, "false statements that obscured the fact that the Moscow project was a lucrative business opportunity, hundreds of millions of dollars," he estimates, "that sought and likely required the assistance of the Russian government." Now, that's interesting because you know who else made false statements to the public about the Moscow project?
I have no dealings with Russia. I have no deals in Russia. I have no deals that could happen in Russia because we've stayed away.
Which brings us to Mueller's second clue. In these documents, Mueller draws a line and asserts that false statements made to the public about Russia could potentially be seen as obstruction of justice, an attempt to limit the investigation, saying when Cohen lied about the Moscow project, quote, "Cohen deliberately shifted the timeline of what occurred in the hopes of limiting the investigation into possible Russian interference into the 2016 U.S. presidential election." So those are two warnings for President Trump and his attorneys. A third warning came from the U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of New York. For the very first time, President Trump was directly implicated by prosecutors in federal crimes. Acting U.S. Attorney Rob Kazami all but naming the president an unindicted co-conspirator and two campaign finance felonies in an effort to influence the 2016 presidential election. Two hush money payments to two women alleging affairs with the president in which Cohen, quote, "acted in coordination with and at the direction of individual one," aka President Trump. The president today called the payments a, quote, "simple private transaction," but in fact, prosecutors describe transactions that were complicated, illegal schemes involving a magazine editor, the purchase of life rights, two different shell corporations, false invoices, and non-disclosure agreements, which, as prosecutors put it, quote, "all of which deceived the voting public." So, totally clears the president? The only image that seems clear to us is the potential constitutional crisis towards which we all seem to be heading. CNN's Jessica Schneider joins me now. And Jessica, it is hard to see how the Southern District of New York implicating the president in the commission of two felonies clears him in any sense of the words.
Yeah, Jake, this filing far from clears the president. And in fact, this criminal allegation out of New York seems to have given the green light to key members of Congress to also look into whether the president's alleged involvement in campaign finance violations, whether it's also an impeachable offense. For the first time, prosecutors are implicating the president in a crime, accusing then-candidate Donald Trump of directing illegal campaign contributions to silence two women who claimed affairs with Trump, all in an effort to influence the 2016 election. Prosecutors in New York telling the judge, as Cohen himself has now admitted, with respect to both payments, he acted in coordination with and at the direction of Individual One.
The next president of the United States.
Individual One referring to President Trump, though he's not directly named in the filing. And with the latest revelation, the incoming chair of the House Judiciary Committee telling Jake on State of the Union, the president's conduct pre-election could set the stage for impeachment.
Well, I think what these indictments and filings show is that the president was at the center of a massive fraud several massive frauds against the American people. Certainly they'd be impeachable offenses. Whether they are important enough to justify an impeachment is a different question.
Now that the president's actions are fully detailed in criminal filings, the president is lashing out on Twitter, calling the payouts a simple private transaction, saying Cohen just trying to get his sentence reduced, witch hunt. The president once said he knew nothing about the payouts to Stormy Daniels and Karen McDougal to secure their silence about alleged affairs.
Do you know about the $130,000 payment to Stormy Daniels?
But audio obtained from September 2016 later showed Trump was fully involved.
I've spoken to Alan Weisselberg about how to set the whole thing up with funding. And it's all the stuff.
The president's business and his family members may also be implicated in the future. New York federal prosecutors have continued to investigate the Trump Organization based on information in the charges against Cohen, CNN has reported. In their filing, federal prosecutors in New York said that Cohen met with prosecutors to discuss the participation of others in the campaign finance crimes. The New York Times reports that New York prosecutors have also examined the statute of limitations on campaign finance violations and believe that charges could possibly be brought against the president if he is not reelected to a second term.
But the president's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, says the filings from Friday showed no evidence implicating the president and also that those payments to the two women weren't campaign contributions anyway. And Jake, as for Michael Cohen, he'll be sentenced on Wednesday and prosecutors have recommended 4 to 5 years in prison. But of course, ultimately, it's up to the judge.
That's right. Southern District of New York saying that he has not been cooperative. Mueller saying he has. Kind of a split decision there.